Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about how to identify the side of a scapula bone. To identify the side of any appendicular skeleton bone, you have to identify three things. One is a feature that identifies superior from inferior. Next is a feature that identifies anterior from posterior. And next is a feature that identifies medial from lateral. Okay, so let us have a look at this bone. This is the scapula bone. As you can see, it is a triangular shaped bone. And you have to identify first, which is the upper and lower side of the scapula, upper and lower parts of the scapula. As you can see here, there are so many processes of the scapula. Okay, this is called the coracoid process, this is called the acromion process, and this is called the glenoid process. All these processes are in the upper end, and in the lower end, you are seeing the lower part of that triangle. So you can identify the upper end and the lower end of the scapula, right? Next, we are going to identify which is the anterior and posterior parts of the scapula. How can you identify that? Scapula, if you look carefully, contains three fossae. And you can see that one fossa is called the subscapular fossa. And on the posterior aspect, you can see, if I turn this around, you can see that there is an infraspinous and a supraspinous fossa. That is separated by a shelf-like process, and that process is called the spine of the scapula. So the spine of the scapula is the prominent process of the scapular blade that projects posteriorly. That is how you identify the posterior aspect of the scapula. So the opposite is the anterior aspect of the scapula. So we have already identified the superior end, inferior end, and the posterior surface and the anterior surface. How did you identify posterior and anterior surface? By identifying the spine of the scapula, which is directed posterior. Now the next is most crucial. How can you identify the medial and the lateral parts of the scapula? This is the one that most students get confused on. Okay, now have a look at the scapula. In this, you can see that the glenoid process, very, very important, the glenoid process will be directed laterally, because you know that the glenoid process is articulating with the head of the humerus, creating the shoulder joint. So the glenoid will be projecting laterally, and the opposite part will be called the medial border of the scapula. The glenoid will be at the lateral glenoid angle. Okay, with that, we can identify the sides of the scapula.